The good shepherd has risen, who laid down his life for his sheep, and willingly died for his flock. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. May your right hand, O Lord, we pray, encompass your family with perpetual health, so that, defended from all wickedness by the resurrection of your only begotten Son, we may make our way by means of your heavenly gift. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There was an attempt in Iconium by both the Gentiles and the Jews, together with their leaders, to attack and stone Paul and Barnabas. They realized it and fled to the Lycaonian cities of Lystra and Derbe, and to the surrounding countryside, where they continued to proclaim the good news. At Lystra there was a crippled man, lame from birth, who had never walked. He listened to Paul speaking, who looked intently at him, saw that he had the faith to be healed, and called out in a loud voice, "Stand up straight on your feet." He jumped up and began to walk about. When the crowd saw what Paul had done, they cried out in Iconian, "The gods have come down to us in human form." They called Barnabas Zeus and Paul Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. And the priest of Zeus, whose temple was at the entrance to the city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates, for he, together with the people, intended to offer sacrifice. The apostles Barnabas and Paul tore their garments when they heard this and rushed out into the crowd shouting, "Men, why are you doing this? We are of the same nature as you, human beings. We proclaim to you good news that you should turn from these idols to the living God, who made heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them. In past generations, he allowed all Gentiles to go their own ways. Yet in bestowing his goodness, he did not leave himself without witness. For he gave you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons, and filled you with nourishment and gladness for your hearts." Even with these words, they scarcely restrained the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, because of your mercy, because of your truth. Why should the pagans say, "Where is their God?"
Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. Whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." Judas, not Iscariot, said to him, "Master, then what happened that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world?" Jesus answered to him, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For today's reading, we are called to renew our faith and devotion to God, to renew our focus, our emphasis on the Lord, to turn once again to him with all our heart, to be faithful in all things and at all times. We are called to put God as the focus and emphasis of our life, that we live our life with God at the center, and we have to be genuine and firm in our faith and dedication at every moment of our life. Today's first reading, we heard how St. Paul and St. Barnabas had faced difficulties and challenges during their missionary activities, facing the plots and opposition from the Jews among the communities who were opposed to their works. They had to flee and find another place to continue their work, where they encountered another challenge, as described in today's passage. As they performed a miracle that healed a man from his sickness, the whole town came to know about it, and they all heralded both St. Paul and St. Barnabas as the coming of their pagan Greek gods in human form, namely that of Zeus and Hercules. St. Paul and Barnabas immediately insisted that they were neither gods nor the heralds of the gods, as the people thought they were. They refused to accept the offerings, sacrifices, and the treatment that they received at the hands of the locals, who worshipped them as if they were their gods walking on earth. Instead, they courageously and firmly preached to the people to turn away from their false and useless worship of the pagan gods, and to embrace the one and only true living God, the one who created the universe. People refused to listen to him, and their works their pagan gods to the dismay of both the apostles. This showed us an immense challenge that the apostles and the missionaries of the Lord faced as they encountered stubborn attitudes and difficulties to change ways of life throughout their missions and journeys. And as we can see, despite the most wonderful and most royal treatment by the people, the two apostles remained firm in their conviction and faith. Certainly, as human beings, no one could not have been tempted by such a treatment. Being treated like God walking on earth, treated as if they own the whole world and everything they asked for would have been easily given to him. But St. Paul and Barnabas both had the right focus and emphasis in their mind and in their heart. And that is the unwavering faith and commitment to God. Surely they must have been tempted, but their faith was strong, and they remained committed to spread the truth and the good news. They have faithfully kept the commandments of God, and they also remained faithful to Him. As the Lord Himself mentioned in today's gospel, indeed, the Lord showed that those who are faithful in Him will be blessed, and God will guide them throughout their journey and works. And that was what St. Paul and St. Barnabas was experiencing. That despite their difficulties and challenges, the wisdom and the strength of the Holy Spirit helped them greatly and enabled them to carry out their missions. Let us now reflect on our own lives. Are we able to follow the Lord faithfully, just as how the apostles had followed Him? So are we able to resist the many temptations being presented in this world? That would say, stay faithful despite the challenges and pressures for us to be unfaithful and abandon the Lord. We have been entrusted with the same mission to continue the work of the apostles, to bear from the truth to God and our fellow men. Let us, thus inspired by the challenges and faith of the apostles, and let us try to dedicate ourselves even more to God. Let us resist the temptations present in this life and this world, and do our best to follow God with all our heart and with all our strength. May the Lord continue to guide us and give us His strength, that we will be able to carry our own journey faithfully as true and dedicated witnesses to the nations, like that of the apostles, the saints, and the martyrs. We bring our needs before our Almighty God with confidence that our prayers will be heard and answered. That our church leaders may be transformed by Christ. That evermore into his image in the preaching of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The leaders of nations and peoples may be guided by the generous and compassionate hand of God in all they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are living without religious freedom may be filled with courage through the grace of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in this faith community may be drawn closer to the Lord in his fullness through the grace of the sacraments. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are alive may know the glory, may know the glory of God and rest in eternal peace at his side. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal intentions and for the intentions of those who ask our prayers. For the sick and the homebound. And for those who are aware of the sacraments, let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
For the intention of this mass, Francis Frank, intention of Sydney and Troy Evans, and Alice Housett, let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
Generous and merciful God, we ask that you listen to the prayers we have placed before you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we are received the bread we offer you. The fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we are received the wine we offer you. The fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his good. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, At all times I blame you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people excels in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new form, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, save us, for by your cross and resurrection you have. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her into fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Richard our Apostolic Administrator, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saints Peter and Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, our God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and born by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who through the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that should be entered in my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us in good. Prayer for the spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here, and unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restored us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our heart the strength of this saving food. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your tithe.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael,
be our angel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan
and all evil
spirits, brought about the world, seeking to ruin souls. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.